Welcome back to an episode of We Are Again, somewhere in the wilderness, and it's time for us to go back to our little camp and finish some set. Wait a minute, what's going on? We must gather a hero party in order to... Yeah, come on. Alright. You can't just get out of there, even if all of the missions are done for. That is absolutely great. Anyway.
Chieftain, how can Grunwar help?
Akrog has some bone dust for Grungwar's plant.
Grungwar. This helps. Very good. No. But it will. Of course.
Nice. I have no idea if it actually gets an additional effect or whatnot if you get additional bone dust ready.
Let Zazga get a proper look.
Chieftain Kabrax. Akrog welcomes him to the Moonkin's strange new home.
Strange indeed, Chieftain Akrog. Kabrax senses much evil here. He tastes corruption in the air. Bah!
The Moonkin has no intention of lingering here for longer than needed, but it is the best place for them to be right now.
The best place, or the only place? They must lead the Bonekin and the Moonkin away from this Temple of Despair. The sooner the better. The corruption Kabrax consents will destroy the trolls if they stay too long. There is no value in hiding here forever.
Akrog can sense it too. It feels like it is growing. But the trolls must stay here until they are ready to fight back. Akrog can only hope that his tribe suffers less here than they would out in the open.
Then Kabrax hopes they will be ready very soon. Oh, and one more thing. About the Moonkin wounded and the rot victims. Kabrax might have an idea how to help them.
Ooh.
It is true. Crabdom.
Oh, again.
That was a strange joke, even for Zazka's mind.
It sounds like it, no? Kabrax is not jesting at all. Crab dung extract is one of the most powerful herbal remedies known to the Bonekin. And while it is true that it not always smells nice, it has kept them hale and strong for many hundred moons. Akrog should go and find some crab dung when they march again on their quest for echoes, or whatever they call them. It will help.
Interesting. where can I find it?
All right. It is worth a thought. Knows Kabrax where they can find crab dung?
Well, crabs are everywhere. But Kabrax knows of a place with lots of colonies. The Cobalt Coast. A couple of brittle bones have made their tribe camp there, so perhaps Akrog could crush them while he's at it.
All right. Akrog will see if the Moonkin can make time. First and foremost, they must focus on resurrecting the cub.
About that, is Akrog really sure? Even if they manage to resurrect that beast, how knows he it will fight for the trolls?
Frankly, Akrog knows not. But he knows that it is their only choice.
Fair point, Akrog. Fair point.
Alright, now let's get more information.
So, Chieftain Kabrax and the Bonekin have been through a lot. Are they recovering?
By the Holy Hide, it has been tough. Tough! Kabrax believed Mugwa could see him through any ordeal, but these last few moons have tested him and his tribe. Kabrax hopes Mugwa will reward her trolls with some peace. At last.
If the Bonekin want peace, Akrog is not sure they came to the right place.
Kabrax understands. But peace takes many forms, Chieftain Akrog. When those cursed greenskins tried to shame Kabrax, he found the peace of Mugwa inside his mind. They treated Kabrax and his tribe like beasts. The Bonekin were filthy, starving, exhausted. Only our inner peace saved us from becoming beasts.
That is an interesting and strange way to see it.
Not strange at all. The path of a chieftain is never clear, but Kabrax has some help. Whenever he is in doubt, Kabrax consults the bones. They tell him which path to take through the power of Mugwa.
And what told the bones, Chieftain Cabrax, when he was trapped by the Greenskins?
The Cabrax need not fear. And by the Holy Hide, that was all he needed to know.
Those bones Chieftain Cabrax wears, can they tell him the future?
Not in the way that Chieftain Akrog might be thinking. When Cabrax throws the bones and reads their patterns, they do not show him exactly what is to come. No. Instead, they help Cabrax decide which of the paths that lay before him is the right one for the Bonekin.
Such guidance sounds valuable enough. How reads Cabrax the patterns?
It is hard to explain to an outsider. Cabrax spent many, many moons studying the power of these bones. If Cabrax were to throw them now, Chieftain Akrog would just see a mess on the ground. Cabrax would see a face, a weapon, or maybe an iron beak. These symbols hold great meaning for the Bonekin.
All right, Akrog must ask. With so much wisdom at their fingertips, how have the Bonekin ended up like this?
Such a question by the Holy Hide. Ah, the wisdom to follow the right path is a true gift. But the right path leads not always to happiness and freedom. The Bonekin walk the path that Mugwa has chosen for them, wherever it may lead. And Cabrax can only consult the bones about the choices he knows he has to make. The future holds surprises for us all, even the Bonekin.
Why was Mugwa's cradle the Bonekin's home? It is such a sacred place.
The chieftain thinks it was wrong to live in such a place. But he knows as well as Cabrax that Urgarth offers little welcome to a tribe of trolls in these times. By the Holy Hide, their choices are few.
That is right enough. But why Mugwa's cradle?
The Bonekin have a solemn duty to serve Mugwa. It is her will that they protect her shrine and treat it with the respect it deserves.
Have the Bonekin never questioned Chieftain Cabrax? Akrog would not blame them for being afraid of bringing enemies to a sacred place.
By the Holy Hide, of course. The faith of the Bonekin runs deep, and many have been worried for the safety of the shrine. When Cabrax explained how Mugwa had brought the tribe to that place, they became calm. If it is the will of Mugwa that the time of trolls is coming to an end, so be it. The Bonekin have made their peace with that. Most of them, anyway.
Well, this is where we differ.
This is where the Moonkin and the Bonekin differ. The Moonkin have faith in Mugwa, it is true. But they also have faith in themselves.
And they have faith in the chieftain?
Akrog hopes so. Akrog has to believe so. But he will never stop trying to earn that faith. Just like he will never stop trying to save his tribe.
Chieftain Akrog has the right to choose his own path. But by the Holy Hide, he should remember, there is more than one way to be saved.
Is there any advice Cabrax would like to give Akrog?
Advice? There is something. But Cabrax is not sure Akrog wants to hear it.
Speak true.
Very well. Akrog should consider carefully who and what he trusts. The way of the Bonekin may seem mysterious to Chieftain Akrog. But Cabrax believes it is far more reliable than following the advice of any brittle bone. And more reliable than trusting the mind of a single troll. The minds of trolls are weak without the guidance of Mugwa. The minds of brittle bones are corrupt and filled with lies.
So what suggests Cabrax? That Akrog puts all his faith into the bones?
Cabrax can only offer. Akrog is the one who decides.
Well, you will think about Cabrax's words. It is quite something to see the Bonekin in battle. So resourceful.
Resourceful? It is true. The Bonekin let nothing go to waste. The blood of the dead and dying gives his tribe the strength of mind to keep on fighting, even when things look bleak. Sharpens their minds. Much like it sharpens Cabrax's reading of the bones.
Hmm, good.
Well, Akrog must leave Cabrax for now. There is much to be done.
Of course. Of course.
Of course. Let's see. Maybe we can give him some more recipes.
Take a closer look.
What is his troll?
Command, yeah.
Look,
well, stone tablets.
Akrog,
there we go.
Found more of those stone tablets. Can the pig and his same blood make use of them?
Still? One would believe you'd have scavenged all the ruins of Urgath by now. Looted. These tablets do look extremely interesting, though. We should be able to shape more things for you very soon. Wilbur should be able, you mean? You'll just stand there saying nonsensical things and pretend you understand what's going on. Now that you say it, perhaps I should become a politician.
Chieftain, got scrap for Zeramak?
Has Anu given Zeramak the boom rock to look at?
It true. Horrible thing. Clever, though. Zeramak try it on rabbit and rabbit not move for a long time. It all right now. Probably.
Could Zeramak make more boom rocks for the Moonkin to use?
As long as he careful not drop them, he can make them. Snoring Master Scrapper, not much help to try.
Zeramak must shape something.
Nice. Okay, it's a consumable then. Perfect. An orb, rare. Now, is it a... Yeah, is it a consumable? Or is it a kind of a trinket item? Who knows? But what do we got here? To enemy creatures in area, purge all active boons. Can set weakened. And we can deal damage. Maybe, yeah. Kind of feels as if this is a weapon that can be used, of course. Similar to scrolls, actually. Except that they are no scrolls. Right. Anything
Little
else on these dudes?
One of the Bonekin tribe, no?
It is true, Chieftain Akrog. Palag is grateful to be here.
Palag seems a little more relaxed than his kin were when Akrog found them.
They must have been filled with the blood sight at the time.
The blood sight? That makes sense.
Palag hopes the chieftain thought not that his kin were being rude.
Far from it. Akrog was impressed by their focus.
It is a blessing from Mugwar. Can Palag help the chieftain with something?
So is it true that Palag drinks blood before fighting his enemies?
Palag drinks the blood. It is true. It fills him with the power of blood sight. It helps him kill many more enemies.
Akrog is curious. How feels Palag when he goes into battle with that power?
How feels it? Palag is not sure if he can describe the full truth of it. Perhaps one day the chieftain will experience it for himself.
Akrog admits he is curious. The idea of letting his body be taken over by such holy powers is a little frightening. And yet, would it make Akrog a better warrior?
Palag hears that the chieftain is already a strong and clever warrior, so it is hard to say. The blood sight completely empties the Troll's mind, so he can focus solely on victory. No feelings of doubt or fear. Palag cannot usually remember the battle afterwards, and it takes a long time for him to notice any wounds. It is freeing.
Perhaps if Akrog was not chieftain, he would take the chance. But the time for such freedom has passed. The Moonkin needs Akrog to be in control, and he will do his duty.
It is a shame, but Palag knows what the chieftain has promised to his tribe. Every troll has his own duty. But maybe, some moons from now, when the trolls have won their freedom, the chieftain can take a day off from duty.
Such freedom is worth striving for. All trolls need a dream like that.
May it not be a dream for long, if Mugwar is willing.
Akrog was wondering, whose blood do the Bonekin drink?
There are a few trolls in Palag's tribe who have been chosen by Mugwar as vessels.
Those trolls offer up their blood whenever Palak and the other warriors need it. The Bonekin's warriors are grateful for any blood they can get. But the truest blood sight comes from the blood of the newly dead.
Even if the dead suffer with a blood rot?
The Bonekin suffer not from the blood rot, Mugwar be praised. But he wonders, if only Palak could taste the blood of Noag, the moon blood.
No drop of Noag's blood will be spilled. Little blood is too important to the Moonkin, to all trolls.
Chieftain, his blood would not go to waste. Far from it. The blood sight from Noag could be just what the Moonkin and Bonekin trolls need to defeat their enemies. If Palak could just try a drop or two.
Palak will stay away from Little Blood. Akrog swore to keep him safe, and he will honor his promise. Palak and his fellow warriors will have to find another way.
Like little mosquitoes.
As the chieftain wishes, Palak hopes he will not regret his choice.
Akrog must apologize to Palak, to all the trolls in his tribe. Akrog feels he brought the enemy into the home of the Bonekin.
Palak cannot speak for every Bonekin, but he blames not the chieftain. It was a time of great sadness for the Moonkin, and Palak knows how such rituals can lessen the pain of loss and despair. The chieftain had no choice.
Perhaps Palak is right, but Akrog still feels a heavy guilt. Did Palak suffer greatly at the hands of the Greenskins?
Not as much as the others. Palak stayed calm, spent the time in silent prayer, resisted the urge to crush his guards. It would only have made things worse for the other Bonekin.
Such quiet strength also has great value. Akrog is glad that Palak came with the Moonkin. They are safer together.
Palak hopes his tribe made the right decision. Maybe he should have gone after those filthy Greenskins. But he should not give in to anger.
Palak may yet get his chance for revenge. For now, he should be patient.
Palak will try his best, but he can only pray for so long.
It is time for Akrog to go.
Palak thanks the chieftain for talking with him.
Ah, chieftain, good of him to come by.
An arm, it is true.
Still alive. That is something, he guess. Enug want to speak to chieftain, because he have idea.
Ooh.
About how they can find more food for their kin.
Well, okay.
Akrog, stay safe, chieftain.
That idea's already conveyed pretty neatly. Alright, so let's just make a little cut in here and continue, of course, with this and Akrog Holmes in the next one, because we could try to maybe get some meat towards the wolf. Until next time, then like and subscribe and ta-ta!